Hi there. In this video, we will discuss the highlights of the blog post, How to Train YOLOX Object Detector on a Custom Dataset. You will be learning what's new in YOLOX, how to train it on a custom dataset, and discuss the results. YOLOX is an interesting addition to the YOLO Object Detector family. The X in YOLOX stands for exceeding the YOLO series in 2021. So, what's new in YOLOX? First of all, unlike previous YOLO networks, YOLOX is going anchor-free. It also introduces advanced detection techniques like decoupled head and simOTA label assignment strategy to achieve state-of-the-art results. Moreover, strong data augmentation like Mosaic and mixUP are incorporated for robust training. Previous YOLO versions used anchor-based pipelines to attain optimal detection performance. Anchors are essentially a very large number of bounding boxes generated through a clustering algorithm. Every object detector performs detection through two subtasks. These are bounding box localization and classification. Here, localization is performed through regression and classification score of each box is obtained. However, anchor-based mechanisms are computationally expensive. It requires many hyperparameters. YOLOX introduces anchor-free mechanism where the assigning strategy is redesigned to per-pixel fashion. Instead of scanning over the entire ground truth, positive samples are limited to center area. This center-based approach is inspired from previous researchers like CornerNet, CenterNet, and FCOS. Next feature is integration of decoupled head. Every YOLO architecture consists of three parts: the backbone, neck, and the head. The backbone extracts features of an image. These features are passed through the neck, obtaining feature maps with multiple scales. Further, the head uses these feature maps to output localization and classification scores. YOLOX moves away from the popular shared head architecture and uses a decoupled head architecture that has separate branches for classification and regression tasks. It is observed that the conversion occurs with significantly lesser epochs compared to a shared head. Label assignment is the process of assigning class labels to the boxes. YOLOX uses an advanced label assignment strategy called simOTA, which helps in reducing the issues that come up with ambiguous anchors. Finally, YOLOX incorporates two types of augmentation techniques, Mosaic and mixUP. With these features, YOLOX is able to achieve performance that is on par with state-of-the-art models. Pre-trained models across various scales are available in the GitHub repository, which is owned by Megvii Technologies. You can choose a model from nano, tiny, small, medium, large, and extra large, depending on the requirement. To train YOLOX models on a custom dataset, you can choose between COCO and Pascal VOC format. We tested the training pipeline using Pascal VOC format with a custom drone dataset. The initial results were decent but not amazing. So, we annotated some more images from the internet and a few from our own recordings. After adding them to the training set, we get pretty good results. We experimented with the models, excluding the extra-large model. After training for 300 epochs, the MAP values of nano, tiny, small, medium, and large models are 74, 76, 80, 83, and 86% respectively. On GTX 1080 Ti, we get 82 FPS for nano, 86 FPS for tiny, and 83 FPS for small models. Pretty much close in performance. The medium model is not very far behind. It gives balanced performance at 66 FPS. On the other hand, the large model, being the most accurate amongst them, performs inference at 43 FPS. CPU inference, however, are not very impressive. These are at least 2 times slower than GPU results. And as the model complexity increases, the inference time increases by many folds. We tested our trained models on various images. These are some of the results that we obtained. As you can see, we deliberately chose these images to fool the models. Clearly, the large model performs better than nano, whereas comparable results are observed in small and medium models. So, that's all about slant features of YOLOX, its training, and results. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it informative. Also, check out other videos in the YOLO series. Like and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.